Motion sensing lights are fascinating. You just tap into a room and the light turns on automatically. How cool is it? These lights work on passive infrared sensors. A passive infrared sensor, or better known as PIR sensor, is an electronic sensor that measures infrared light radiating from any object in its field of view. They are most often used in PIR-based motion detectors. PIR sensors are commonly used in security alarms and automatic lighting applications. These sensors are available online at cheap prices. If we search for a motion sensing light, there are plenty of options available. But why should we spend money when we can make it at our home? In this video, I will teach you how to build a motion sensing light at home with basic components. Before continuing with this video, make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notifications for my upcoming tutorials and project like this. Hey guys, my name is Prashant Sharma and you are watching RoboCircuits. Let's get started. For making a motion sensing light, we need number 1, PIR sensor. The main part of this build will be the sensor. It is capable of detecting motions by humans. The human body radiates infrared light, which is detected by the two detectors inside a PIR sensor, which then creates an electrical signal according to its motion. If you want to read about its working in detail, then you can check out the article about this in the description of this video. The second component is relay module. Light bulbs work on 220 volt AC. To control it, we need a relay module. Then the third component is power supply. The PIR and the relay works on 5 volt DC. To convert 220 volt AC to 5 volt DC, we need a power supply. If you have a spare mobile charger or any adapter, you can take out its circuit and use it directly. I am using this Hi-Link power supply. It's a little expensive, but the 5 volt charger will work fine. Then we need a NPN or a PNP transistor. The PIR sensor gives an output from 0 to 3 volt, which is not sufficient to trigger our 5 volts relay. So we need a transistor in between. You can either use an NPN or a PNP transistor. I have a BC558 PNP transistor. You can use a NPN also. I will give you all circuits in the article and the link to that article will be in the description. Then we also need some resistance for the same circuit. Finally, we need an LED light bulb. An LED light bulb of sufficient size is needed so that all the components discussed above can fit inside it. As I fit a segue to the sponsor of this video, Altium. Altium Designer enables engineer to effortlessly connect with every facet of electronic design process. Over 35 years of innovation and development focused on a truly unified design environment makes it the most widely used PCB design solution. Altium 365, which is one of their service, is the electronic product design platform that unites PCB designing, MCAD, data management and teamwork at one place. Set your organization up to a success with flexible control for team management and project visibility. Get 1 month free from the link in the description of this video. Let's start building it. Open the bulb's uppercase. Then you will find a LED plate. Remove it. Under it, you will see two wires. These are the main AC wires. I unsoldered these two wires to remove the main LED plate. As you can see, we have enough space to fit all the components inside this case. We have to connect all the components according to this circuit. Here, the relay is controlling the power going to the LED plate. The relay is being controlled by the PIR sensor. The transistor is acting as a bridge between the PIR's 3 volt output and the relay's 5 volt input. Finally, we have the power supply, which is supplying 5 volts for the modules. Let's complete the circuit by soldering the components together. And the circuit is completed. Now you can test it outside if you want. Then carefully place the relay, the power supply and the transistor circuit. Make sure their wires are not touching each other and there is no wire that is feeling any unusual strain. Keep the PIR outside and close the case with the LED plate. Finally, we need the bulb cover. In the bulb cover, we need to make a huge hole on the exact center of this hemispherical cover to hold the PIR sensor. Now we can paste the PIR sensor with the cover using some glue. Then we have to close it and we are ready to test it. But before testing, we have two potentiometers on the PIR. The one is used to control sensitivity and the other is used to control the time. Set them according to your needs. Make sure to keep sensitivity to high and time to about 1 or 2 minutes. Then close the bulb and we are ready to rock. We can plug the bulb in the holder and turn it on. I used it in my washroom. Whenever I enter my washroom, the bulb turns on automatically. I found this light really useful at night. These can be used in stairs, front doors, balconies, and storerooms. They will not only provide us comfort, but also saves a lot of energy. This was it for this video. Hope you find it useful. If yes, don't forget to like this video and drop your useful comments in the comment section. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.